I think that resonance is growing.
In all of these new areas, what we find is, you know, there's so much terminology. Viable systems approach is a whole language. Maybe not as complex as Italian, but it's very complex language. The service science community, the handbook of service science, which is about to come out, is almost 800 pages long. These are lots of words to learn the meanings of.
Perché dobbiamo andare avanti, capito?
Together, the possibility of new synergy with the service science and the viable system.
Oh, thank you so much.
Friendly, friendly possible.
Thank you.
Grazie per essere qui a Roma con noi.
Thank you for staying here.
My pleasure.
If you have questions,
Non c'è nessuno.
Hi, I was wondering about your definition of service as value co-creation. Why don't you add or consider also value sharing? Because when we talk or speak about value, do research on value, we always have the creation moment, but also the moment of claiming the value we have created. So since co-creation involves a relationship between a provider and a customer, as you said, besides co-creating, there's then a moment in which both the provider and the customer claim the value they have created. So maybe service science could be could have a broader perspective and include also the value claiming moment or the value sharing.
In some of the early definitions, we actually said the creation and capture of value, which I think, but we started to move away from that when we were influenced by Vargo and Less, service dominant logic. Mm-hmm. And what they helped us understand, I think, was that you have to really think about the two entities. So we would be more likely to call it co-sharing now. You know, there's, it's, you know, sharing, I guess, has that meaning that you're dividing it somehow, but we're really trying to emphasize with value co-creation that it has to be two entities. So yeah, I think your point is a valid one. I'm not sure exactly how I would say sharing.
Yeah. So you're not actually splitting something, you're just creating it together.
It's more complex in that, you know, how do you share reputation, or how do you share, I mean, if we're in goods dominant logic and we want to share a book, well, we just get two copies, or you have it part of the time and I have it part of the time. But with service, what we're trying to talk about is something that's not not like a product. So the sharing concept would have to be something that would reflect these processes of valuing, I think, a little bit more. But I'll have to think about it. That's a good point.
Okay, and one more thing, one quote you could add, because I found that I think it's very fascinating to frame service science within the evolutionary perspective. And one more quote you could add is a quote by Einstein. You probably know it. Is that he used to say, it seems to me that our times are characterized by clarity as to means and confusion as to ends. So I think that we have manufacturing, which to me is the means or the technology. But we have a little bit more of a confusion about ends or the use we can make of the technology and the manufacturer we have. So probably service science can help to bring some clarity on the ends, because we have quite a lot of means we can use, but ends are not so clear.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm working on a paper right now that talks about means, ends, and context in the context of service science.
And even Herbert Simon wrote a lot about means and ends chains.
Yes. Yes. In Vargo and Lush, they talk about operant and operand resources, and think that, you know, well, I'm not going to go into it, but I could. I'd like to hear other questions. I think Francesco, you have some thoughts.
Yeah, I was wondering about, you know, academic from the base research perspective or from a traditional perspective, understand sciences as the traditional sciences. And so
Physics is the classic.
And I was willing to hear your point in a parallel with the computer science and service science, and just to giving us a time perspective of this proposal, because maybe what was not clear in your presentation was a concrete time perspective of some results, which may be real far away, which doesn't mean that are not interesting, they are challenging, but
yes.
I was willing to hear your point on this.
Yeah, so I think physics is one of the oldest, math and physics are some of the oldest disciplines. Computer science is very recent. The first computer science department arguably was in 1945 at Columbia University. What's interesting, that first computer science course at Columbia had a computer they used. Transistors weren't invented until 1949. It was a computer built before transistors. So math and physics are ancient. Computer science is 60 years old. Service science, you can argue, is, some people would say it's 30 years old because there were pioneers that were working on it. Some people would say it's less than 10 years old. So it's very, very new. Operations research is about 50 or 60 years old. Business is a discipline. Management schools started in 1910 to spread. So they're about 100 years old. Economics. Where do you want to argue economics starts? A lot of people say with Adam Smith. So it's about 300 years old. I think what we see in service science is an embryonic, a really, really embryonic early stage need for a science. The phenomena of value co-creation is ancient. Value co-creation goes way, 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 way back. But studying value co-creation scientifically in the complexity of technology-enabled service systems, it would be hard to imagine it being older than computer science, because a lot of the new services couldn't exist without computers. So it's a very, very young, early stage field. A lot of people, when they first heard about service science, would come up to me and put their hand on my shoulder and say, oh, you're talking about operations research, or industrial engineering, or management of information systems, or economics, or, but I gave the talk at so many universities, and every university it was a different discipline saying, we're already doing it, we're already doing it, we're already doing it, which is why I know it's a very complex diagram, and it's in a paper that's coming out shortly, but it really is, you know, it's trying to think of how do all of these disciplines relate to value co-creation. What, you know, if I had to say there was a problem with economics, because economics is big and vast, so there's no problem with economics, but most of economics focuses on value as money. Value as money. And what about reputation? Or what about open source communities that are creating value these days? So unfortunately, economics, the center of economics, leaves out some of the most important new innovations that service science has to draw on. Operations research, again, has some wonderful things. But if you look at all of these different disciplines, they're good for certain types of value and certain types of systems. But they're not good for thinking about all the different types of value co-creation and all the different types of systems. And so that's really the thing I think important to say is service science is very new compared to these other disciplines.